up y'all, welcome back, it's me Laila. If you're new here, hello. If you haven't subscribed already yet, subscribe already and join the fam. I would really appreciate it. Anyways, thank you for stopping by. You guys have seen the title, so y'all know what today's video is going to be about. I'm going to stop with my rambling because I know it bores people out. If you're interested in knowing how to look more put together and at the same time modest, keep watching. Started with today's video, I want to give you all a small gist on what dressing modestly is more about. Whenever the word modest is uttered, people usually have this misconception that it's more about wearing baggy, loose and not so fitted clothes. But it's about wearing clothes that cover your entire body, but at the same time you're wearing loose clothes which have structure, which has a little bit of form and which is a little bit fitted, but at the same time it's not completely giving away your curves, your figure. First tip that I'm going to share with y'all is confidence. Having confidence in yourself is so, so important. I'm not talking about being overconfident and I'm not talking about being underconfident, but at least be in a level that you're confident in yourself, confident in your body so that you know how to present yourself, you know how to carry yourself. And secondly, your posture also plays a major key role in whatever you're wearing, in wherever you're going. If you slouch or if you, you know, do this, then it shows how lazy you are. So work on making your posture stiff and straight and not doing this, not slouching. No, that's a big no-no. So work on your posture, work on your confidence. Y'all can do a few exercises that makes you work on your posture and at the same time, confidence. Talk to yourself in the mirror. Talk for at least 15 to 20 minutes a day. In this way, you can build eye contact with yourself and the next time you're talking to someone, you're sure that you're comfortable in your body, but at the same time you can maintain eye contact with the other person and you're confident enough. In order to look more put together and more presentable is making sure that your clothes are ironed and to cut down all the threads that is wobbling from your clothes. It makes you look so much more put together and so much more presentable and it shows that you're not lazy. Third tip is more about modesty, and if you're someone who does not like showing your butt, in general you're not supposed to show your butt, but anyways, invest in some good cardigans, invest in some good jackets and some coats which can be multi-purpose. That is, you can wear it with anything that you want. If you're wearing jumpsuit, you can wear it over that. If you're just tucking in your shirt, you can wear it over that. Or in general, if you're going for styles where your booty is being shown, then you can just throw a cardigan or you can just throw.
Here's a small example of how I have paired my cardigan with my outfit. In this way, my booty is covered and I look modest.
This is one hack that I have learned and I have been adopting recently. If you're going for a more street style look, then this is what you can do. If you have a shirt or in general, if you have a full sleeved shirt or a cardigan, you can just wrap it around your waist and in that way it gives your waist a little bit more waistline and at the same time your booty is being covered.
Here's an example of how I have gone for a more street style look by wrapping a shirt around my waist. In this way, I get a little bit more waistline and a lot more coverage.
My next tip would be investing in some neutral pieces, or in general, have your wardrobe filled with neutral pieces. I know some people may not like it, but I am a big, big neutral fan. Neutrals can vary from whites to dark blacks, blues. In between can be grays, it can be camel, it can be pastels, it can be in general brown, or you know, just see the color palette online and you just get a huge variety of neutral colors. It just makes you look so much more classy, so much more chic and so much more elegant. And if you're someone who loves wearing bold colors, say red, say bright pink, then what you can do is tone it down with neutrals. That is, if you're wearing a bright, bold top, then you can wear pants which are neutral, say cream, say brown, say mauve. There are so many neutral colors and it just makes you look so much more put together and I don't know, in general makes you look so much more
clean. Okay, here's two of my favorite shades which I have paired together.
So my next tip in order to look more modest is invest in some good undershirts. Shirts that are according to your skin color, or in general invest in some neutral undershirts. I would suggest invest in cotton and cotton mix rayon. If you don't find cotton, you can find it on H&M and Zara, I believe. Yes, you get it on H&M. Not sure about Zara, but I'll check it out and link it down in the description box. Anyways, investing in some good undershirts is so, so good. If you're wearing white, then you obviously need to wear something neutral underneath because you can never wear white over white. Whenever summer is around the corner, we stick on to wearing long maxi-length dresses, which sometimes can be a little bit loose and a little bit baggy. So what we can do in order to avoid the bagginess and at the same time look more put together and modest is wearing a belt around your waist. So in that way, it takes your outfit to the next level, but at the same time, you're not completely giving away your figure.
Okay, this is what the actual dress looks like, a little bit loose. But once I finish wearing the belt, it basically takes the dress from drab to fab. And it shows that I have thrown in a little bit extra effort into dressing up.
So my next tip in order to look more put together is making sure that you choose outfits in the same shade or around the same shade. That is going for monochromatic looks or wearing monochrome outfits. It is so in style, looks so much more classier, so much more chic and elegant. Okay, so what I would suggest you guys is to invest in some good pair of pants. I'm not talking about jeans, I'm talking more about dress pants, trousers, loose baggy fitted pants that you find comfortable, that you can mix and match it with a bunch of different colors and a bunch of different outfits.
Here's a small example of my favorite set of pants.
Last tip is play with your accessories, but do not wear more than 32 accessories. It's styling 101 that you're not supposed to wear more than 32 accessories on your body, which includes your headpieces, your jewelry, your footwear, your bag in general. And play with dainty jewelry, that is small, elegant jewelry. Play in colors of gold, say rose gold, say in general gold, makes it look so much more chic. And at the same time, play with bags, play with different types of bags.
Here's a small example of how I have transformed this super lazy look into that of a street style look with the help of this bag.
So that is it for today's video. I hope you all liked it. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you haven't already. And one more thing, don't forget to turn on the post notifications. It's important, so turn it on so that you all get notified every time I post a new video. Moreover, you guys know the drill. Subscribe, like, share and comment, and see you all in my next video. Bye!